middle of this crap? What fully qualified arsehole stops to kill a cook?
They always kill the servants first, my dear. Otherwise they could run and warn someone.
Oh sure, reasonable, innit? Friggin' garbage.
was he doing here?
This man was a Council of Herald's emissary. Curious to find him here.
The crest of the Chalon family. Duke Gaspard will answer for this.
Time to have a word with the Duke.
No! No!
Watching this approach. They're organized.
Thank you.
fancy meeting you here. Inquisitor Kadash. What an historic moment. The first Carter thug in all Thedas invited to court. We haven't been properly introduced, have we? I'm Ambassador Briala.
Ambassador, is it? Whose ambassador are you, exactly?
If the nobility is going to treat elves as if we are not citizens, we may as well have the trappings of a foreign power. You clean this place out. We'll take a month to get all the Tevinter blood off the marble. I came down to save or avenge my missing people. But you've beaten me to it. So, the Council of Errol's emissary in the courtyard. That's not your work, is it?
If I did kill him, what would you do?
Well, I wouldn't believe you, for one. You may have arrived with the Grand Duke, but you don't seem to be doing his dirty work. I knew he was smuggling his chevaliers, but killing a council emissary? Bringing Tevinter assassins into the palace? Those are desperate acts. Gaspar must be planning to strike tonight.
Are you sure he's behind this? He was too easygoing for a man plotting treason.
Don't let his charm blind you. He's Orlesian. That smile is his mask. I misjudged you, Inquisitor. You might just be an ally worth having. What could you do with an army of elven spies at your disposal? You should think about it.
You know how to make a sales pitch, Ambassador. I'll give you that.
I do, don't I? I know which way the wind is blowing. I'd bet coin that you'll be part of the peace talks before the night is over. And if you happen to lean a little bit our way, it could prove advantageous to us both. Just a thought.
Mop. Politics and double dealing. Is there anyone here who is not corrupt?
It's the game, my dear. Everyone plays it here.
Must be something here. Thank you.
An elven locket, stored away in a palace safe. Unwise, Celine.
Is it true what they say? You're the Inquisitor, are you not? We heard stories of your accomplishments.
I'd wager I have better tales than anything you've heard.
I told you, Philippe.
Not everyone fights an archdemon and lives to tell. It's an inspiration.
If you like, Commander Cullen could give you all the details of that battle. He's in the ballroom.
Really? But I shouldn't leave my post.
You'd only be gone a moment.
Philippe, the world is coming to an end. If we don't hear this story now, we'll never have a chance.
You're right. Thank you, Inquisitor. Let's go.
Might be something here. Better take a closer look.
Inquisitor Kadash, we met briefly. I am Grand Duchess Floriane de Chalon. Welcome to my party.
Why am I not at all surprised that you want to see me now?
This is Orlais, Inquisitor. Nothing happens by accident. I believe tonight you and I are both concerned by the actions of a certain person. Come, dance with me. Spies will not hear us on the dance floor.
Very well. Shall we dance, Your Grace?
I'd be delighted. I've never thought the Carter could tell one human from another. Just how much do you know about our civil war?
What do you think I ought to know?
My brother and my dear cousin have been at each other's throats for too long. It took great effort to arrange tonight's negotiations, yet one party would use this occasion for blackest treason. The security of the Empire is at stake. Neither one of us wishes to see it fall.
Do we both want that, Lady Florian?
I hope we are of one mind on this.
In times like these, it's hard to tell friend from foe. Is it not, Your Grace?
I know you arrived here as a guest of my brother, Gaspar, and have been everywhere in the palace. You are a curiosity to many, Inquisitor, and a matter of concern to some.
Am I the curiosity or the concern to you, Your Grace?
A little of both, actually. This evening is of great importance, Inquisitor. I wonder what role you will play in it. Do you even yet know who is friend and who is foe? Who in the court can be trusted?
An excellent question. I might ask the same of you, Your Grace.
In the Winter Palace, everyone is alone. It cannot have escaped your notice that certain parties are engaged in dangerous machinations tonight.
I thought dangerous machinations were the national sport in Orlais.
You have little time. The attack will come soon. You must stop Gaspar before he strikes. In the Royal Wing Garden, you will find the captain of my brother's mercenaries. He knows all Gaspar's secrets. I'm sure you can persuade him to be forthcoming.
We'll see what the night has in store, won't we?
You'll be the talk of the court for months. We should take you dancing more often.
It's a relief to do something other than fight demons and horrors.
You still face demons and horrors. These ones are simply better dressed.
Were you dancing with Duchess Florian?
More importantly, what happened in the servants' quarters? I heard there was fighting.
I hope you have good news. It appears the peace talks are crumbling.
The Grand Duchess tried to convince me Gaspard is the traitor, but I'm not sure I buy it.
Florian and her brother are thick as thieves, but she would give him up in an instant to save herself.
Then, the attack on the Empress will happen tonight.
Warning Celine is pointless. She needs these talks to succeed, and to flee would admit defeat. Then perhaps we should let her die.
I thought we were here to stop the assassination.
Listen to me carefully, Inquisitor. What Corypheus wants is chaos. Even with Celine alive, that could still happen. To foil his plan, the Empire must remain strong. This evening, someone must emerge victorious.
And it doesn't need to be Celine. She's right.
Do you realize what you're suggesting, Leliana?
Sometimes the best path is not the easiest one.
We came here to save Celine.
Then you must not only save her life, but also her empire.
That means giving her a victory over both Gaspard and Briala.
If there truly is proof Gaspard's in league with Corypheus, that would be a start.
What did Duchess Florian tell you?
She said Gaspard's mercenary captain is in the Royal Wing, that he knows about the assassination.
Which could be a trap.
Or a lead. Either way, you should search the private quarters in that wing for clues.
Then get me access. And in the meantime, get your soldiers into position.
At once. Be careful, Inquisitor.
still remember the day they came to tell me that my second husband, Philippe, was
Mistress Nightingale. What a pleasure to see you again.
You are an interesting one. A dwarf from the Carter, of all places, with the manners of a noble. The Merchant Guild will be outraged.
I'd like your opinion of this gathering, my lady.
It's doomed to fail, of course. Celine knows that. At least it should be amusing. We haven't had such a menagerie at court in living memory.
Have you noticed anything odd this evening?
Too few Imperial Guards stand in attendance, my dear. A shame. They are so pleasantly decorative.
Good evening, my lady.
Nightingale, what a pleasure to see you again. You look radiant.
Marquis, it's been far too long. How's your family in Valchevin?
No complaints, my dear, no complaints. You must come to the chateau to see the girls. They will be overjoyed.
Oh, I've missed them very much. Little Sylvie must be 10 now, no?
11, and already up to my elbow. Oh, how they grow.
Perhaps I shall call on you soon.
Excellent. Now I must dance with the Dowager. It was lovely to see you, my dear.
Ugh. So many crimes of fashion.
I found this out. I'm not sure of its value.
This is good work.
Must be Inquisitor Kadash. I've heard stories. You've charmed some of the nobles. We'll see how long you can keep their favor. What brings you to me?
I want to know more about the peace talks. What are you hoping to gain from tonight's negotiations?
A voice. Simple enough, isn't it? My people have none. We've lived for centuries amid the lowest ranks of society. No one hears us. No one sees us. If the elves of Halam Shiral were elevated, if we had an elven noble at court, we'd have recognition. A voice.
How much can a single member of the court do?
It won't remake the world overnight, if that's what you're asking. Our problem is invisibility. The people in power are used to ignoring us. We're not actors, we're scenery. We need elves in positions where they can't be overlooked. We need to force humans to take us seriously.
How will you persuade the Empress to elevate an elf to nobility?
It is already in place. Celine knows she needs us to tip the balance of the civil war in her favor. All we have to do is wait. She'll exhaust her other options and come to us for help. Then, we'll name our price.
Everyone should have representation in their government.
A start. That's all this is. Something humans can't ignore, and something elves can aspire to. But that's the future. We need to focus on the task at hand.
If Celine were killed, what would happen to your plans?
As assuming I'm not the one blamed? It would be precarious. I've been working on Gaspard, but he's like a charging bull. It would be easier to rein him in if I had something that could hurt him.
I had a question about you, Brianna.
I'm an elf, Inquisitor. That should tell you everything you need to know about my life. I'm good at what I do. That's all that matters. I will help my people no matter the cost.
What's your story? How is an elf invited to the Empress's ball as an ambassador?
Empress Celine and I have history. There was a time when I put my spies at her disposal. She knows my qualifications. We had a falling out. Now we are negotiating to determine whether I return to her side in the war.
What do you mean, we had a falling out?
She betrayed me. Turned me over to the guards on a trumped-up charge to save her political reputation. It wasn't personal. It's the game. That's how all Orlesians justify these things to themselves. It wouldn't do to let the court know she had an elven friend.
I'm surprised you'd admit that. Considering the circumstances.
I know it's incriminating. Few harbor more resentment against Celine than I. But if she died after inviting me here, the court would certainly pin her death on me. An elf assassinating the Empress? Alienages across Orle, across all Thedas, would be purged. That cannot happen.
I've been told you were romantically involved with the Empress.
I didn't take you for a gossip monger, Inquisitor. I suppose your spies have already briefed you, so there's no point in pretending. Yes, Celine and I were lovers once, but we've gone our separate ways now.
I found an elven locket hidden among Celine's things. This isn't yours, is it?
Let me see that. She kept this. What was she thinking? If Gaspard had found this, it would have ruined her.
It might have meant something to her.
Maybe it did. She held on to it.
You might be interested in what I've found. It's about Gaspard. He's been threatening the nobles on the Council of Heralds.
Typical. Gaspard's always been a bully, regardless of the Chevalier Code.
I found orders issued to his general to sneak troops into the palace.
My people reported Chevaliers skulking around where they shouldn't be. It's a foolish move if he doesn't succeed. Sneaking men in is easy. Getting them out unnoticed is not.
You think Gaspard was behind the murder of that council emissary and the Tevinter agents in the servants' wing?
Gaspard is ruthless. He wants the throne. But to conspire with Tevinter, that's low even for him. If you intend to stop him, you'll need irrefutable proof. His supporters will accept nothing less. Celine will never end the talks until she has no other choice.
We'll speak more later, Ambassador.
Another time, Inquisitor. Inquisitor, to what do we owe this honor?
We are always delighted to speak with you, of course.
Her Imperial Majesty is unfortunately occupied at present.
Perhaps you could tell me something. We haven't been properly introduced.
How rude of us to forget.
My Lord Inquisitor, allow me to present Lady Couteau.
And Lady Colombe.
And of course, Lady Fleur. We are the Empress's ladies-in-waiting.
I'd like to know more about Empress Selene.
Her Majesty has held the throne since she was just 16 years old.
She is respected and beloved, not just in Orle, but across Thedas.
She doesn't care much for liver, and she drinks her tea black.
My investigations turned up something interesting. I made a fascinating discovery. An elven locket in the Empress's vault.
Oh dear. That is very interesting.
I'll get Her Majesty.
Inquisitor, I regret that we did not have time to speak earlier. No doubt you have questions about many things.
The locket I found. It was a gift from Briala, wasn't it?
She gave it to me for my coronation. I don't know why I kept it. It was a foolish thing to do.
What made the two of you part ways?
She wanted change, and she thought I should deliver it. My word is law, Inquisitor, but laws don't command people's hearts. Culture does not transform itself overnight. I failed her. I should have dared more. But the past, like so many things, is beyond my command.
Maybe you kept it because you still care for Briala.
Perhaps I do. But I cannot put her above all the people of my empire. Dispose of the locket however you like. It means nothing to me.
Such beautiful hair, Commander.
Thank you.
Maximilian Swift.
That's useful. Interesting. Just gossip.
room after room, and for what? Ruffle storage? Real useful.
Hello? Is anyone there?
No!
I hope you're not disappointed I stole your dance partner.
No, not at all. No one's supposed to be here. Briala said... Oh, I shouldn't have trusted her.
Briala told you to come to this wing of the palace?
Not personally. The ambassador can't be seen talking to the servants. We get coded messages at certain locations, but the order came from her. She's been watching the Grand Duke all night. No surprise she wanted someone to search his sister's room.
So this room belongs to Grand Duchess Floriane?
It used to. This had been her private room in Halam Sheral since she was a child. But this part of the palace was damaged, and the royal family moved to the guest wing.
What were you trying to find in Florian's old room?
The message didn't say. I should have known it was a setup.
This wing is sealed. How did you get in here?
Easy. The door was unlocked. One of the others probably handled it.
Is there anyone else who knows the code in the drop location who could have written those orders?
I don't know. Any of us could do it, but... No. No one else would send me here. It had to be Briala.
It takes great courage to come to the royal wing unarmed.
It's not courage to blindly follow Briala's orders into a trap. I knew her. Before, when she was Celine's pet. Now she wants to play revolution, but I remember. She was sleeping with the Empress who purged our alienage.
Something like that could destroy Briala if it were known.
No. Some know she has a history with the Empress. But they believe she was just a favored servant. If the Inquisition will protect me, I'll tell you everything I know about our ambassador.
Knew it. I did. And I bet the hate made it feel real good.
Go to the ballroom. Find Commander Cullen. He'll keep you safe.
Thank you. Make her protect you, Inquisitor.
What's this then? Swapping all the gold leaf with diamonds, I bet.
You painted on Legion assholes!
Inquisitor, what a pleasure. I wasn't certain you'd attend. You're such a challenge to read. I had no idea if you'd taken my bait.
I fear I'm a bit busy at the moment, if you were looking for a dance partner.
Yes, I see that. Such a pity you did not save one final dance for me. It was kind of you to walk into my trap so willingly. I was so tired of your meddling. Corypheus insisted that the Empress die tonight, and I would hate to disappoint him.
At this point, I'd think disappointment was an old friend.
Poor dear. You can't begin to imagine what Calpurnia and I have in store. And now I suppose you never will. In their darkest dreams, no one imagines I would assassinate Celine myself.
All I need is to keep you out of the ballroom long enough to strike. A pity you'll miss the rest of the ball, Inquisitor. They'll be talking of it for years. Kill him and bring me his marked hand. It will make a fine gift for the Master.
Just his tits. What was all that? Were those demons? There aren't any more of those blasted demons coming, right?
No more demons. It's safe.
Maker? I've never seen one that close before. I knew Gaspard was a bastard, but I didn't think he'd feed me to fucking horrors over a damn bill.
You honestly believe you were captured, tied up, and thrown into a death trap because of a bill?
When you put it like that, it seems a bit odd. The Duke wanted to move on the palace tonight, but he didn't have enough fancy chevaliers. So he hired me and my men. He had to offer us triple our usual pay to come to Orlais. Stinking punsy cheesemongers.
He's going to attack tonight. What about the peace talks?
Nobles don't give a shit about honor and conduct unless it suits them. He'll do what it takes to claim the throne.
Impressively ruthless of Gaspard, if predictable.
We're after one assassin, right? Should the rest just queue up?
You saved my life. I owe you. And Gaspard still hasn't paid me. You want me to talk to the Empress or the court or sing a blasted song in a chantry? I'll do it.
Thank you.
thank the Maker you're back. The Empress will begin her speech soon. What should we do?
Wait here, Cullen. I'm going to have a word with the Grand Duchess.
What? There's no time. The Empress will begin her speech any moment.
We owe the court one more show, Your Grace.
Inquisitor?
The eyes of every noble in the Empire are upon us, Your Grace. Remember to smile. This is your party. You wouldn't want them to think you had lost control.
Who would not be delighted to speak with you, Inquisitor?
I seem to recall you saying, all I needed was to keep you out of the ballroom long enough to strike. When your archers failed to kill me in the garden, I feared you wouldn't save me this last dance. It's so easy to lose your good graces. You even framed your brother for the murder of a council emissary. It was an ambitious plan. Celine, Gaspard, the entire Council of Heralds, all your enemies under one roof.
This is very entertaining, but you do not imagine anyone believes your wild stories.
That will be a matter for a judge to decide, cousin.
Gaspard, you cannot believe this. You know I would never... Gaspard?
You lost this fight ages ago, Your Grace. You're just the last to find out. Your Imperial Majesty, I think we should speak in private. Elsewhere.
Your sister attempted regicide in front of the entire court, Gaspard.
You're the spymaster. If anyone knew this atrocity was coming, it was you.
You don't deny your involvement.
I do deny it. I knew nothing of Florian's plans. But you... You knew it all and did nothing.
I don't know which is better. That you think I'm all-seeing? Or that you're trying so hard to play innocent, and failing.
Enough! We will not bicker while Tevinter plots against our nation. For the safety of the Empire, I will have answers.
I wouldn't have caught Florian in time without Briala's help.
You were working together?
Of course.
We have the note from your general ordering him to move troops covertly into the palace grounds.
It was a defensive choice. I expected betrayal here, just not by my own sister.
Keep talking, Gaspard. Eventually, you'll convince somebody.
There were also the threats Gaspard made to the Council of Heralds to bully them into giving him the crown.
Gaspard is a bully. Is that the worst you can say of me?
And his mercenary captain will be happy to tell you all their plans for the coup tonight. Briala found all of this out for your sake, Celine.
In light of overwhelming evidence, we have no choice but to declare you an enemy of the Empire. You are hereby sentenced to death.
I think Ambassador Briala deserves some reward for uncovering all this.
I can scarcely believe you did all this for me,
Celine.
Thank you, Inquisitor, for all your efforts tonight. I owe you my life, and Orly owes you its future. You have done so much for my people and for us.
We won't forget this.
It was my pleasure. The two of you deserve to be happy.
We truly are. Come, stand with us, Inquisitor. We must give the good news to the nobility. Lords and ladies of the court, this is a night for celebration. Those who sought to poison our empire with treason have been brought to justice. It is a new age for Orlais. We shall build a world in which all men and women live in harmony. Let the cornerstone of change be laid. I introduce the newest member of our court, Marquise Briala of the Dales.
This is not just a victory in Halam Shiral, or within the Empire, or even for elves alone. This is a triumph for everyone! Over 1,000 years ago in the Valerian fields, elves and humans together defeated the Imperium. We can do so much more now. We are greater than our ancestors ever dreamed. Together, we will start by saving our world from the enemy who took the divine and tore the sky apart.
This evening proves what we can accomplish through cooperation.
We are already tracking these Tevinter agents. Soon they'll have no place to hide.
But that is tomorrow. Tonight, we celebrate our newfound fellowship. Let the festivities commence!
The Orlesian nobility make drunken toasts to your victory, and yet you are not present to hear them. Do you tire so quickly of their congratulations, Inquisitor? 'Tis most fickle, after all your efforts on their behalf.
Everyone suddenly wants to talk to me. You, at least, I'm glad to see.
Then I have happy news, as you shall be seeing a great deal more of me. By Imperial decree, I have been named liaison to the Inquisition. Celine wishes to offer you any and all aid, including mine. Congratulations.
Welcome to the Inquisition, Morrigan.
A most gracious response. I shall meet you at Skyhold.
I can't believe you escaped before me. A fat count insisted on talking about soup for 15 minutes. We can return to Skyhold whenever you like. The sooner the better. Is something wrong?
I wish I could have saved the Grand Duke. His death was needless.
He died with dignity. It could have been far worse, considering his treachery. We will need to put the soldiers at Skyhold on alert. Better to be safe.
Wait. There is one thing we must do before we go. May I have this dance, Lady Cassandra?
A dance? After all we've been through tonight?
Can you think of a better way to celebrate?
I suppose this isn't terrible.
The matter is urgent, Lady Josephine.
I am well aware of that, revered mother.
We will need them to return to Valroyo as soon as possible. There are ceremonies, ordinations. Make us mercy.
That's quite impossible at the moment. However, I will see to this matter as soon as possible.
My Lord Inquisitor. Please, may I have a word with you?
How may I assist you, revered mother?
With the political turmoil put to rest, our minds turn to a single question. The next divine. We cannot answer it without the left and right hands of divine Justinia the Fifth.
I have already told you, revered mother. Lady Leliana and Sigar Cassandra cannot be spared from their duties.
But surely with the support of the Empire, the Inquisition will not be harmed by the loss of just two souls.
Leona and Cassandra would have to make that decision for themselves.
And they certainly will, at a later date. The Inquisitor has only just returned and has important business to attend to. You must excuse us, revered mother. Don't let them detract from your victory at Alamshiral. We've beaten his wardens and stopped his intrigues. Soon, Corypheus will have no place to hide. Cullen is hoping to press our advantage. We'll plan our next attack when you're ready.
Good place to pick yourself up and dust off.
Will you not consider it, Lady Cassandra? The clerics are still sequestered. If no one steps forward, they will debate until...
And you think I could make them agree? I've heard enough for one day, Mother Giselle.
Talk to her, your worship.
The fun never ends in Skyhold, does it?
Are all dwarves such comedians? Or just you and Varric? I assume you've heard that Leliana and I are both candidates to be the next divine. Because of what happened at Halamshiral, of course, the Empire favors you. Thus, everyone close to you. So now the Chantry bandies our names about without even asking us first.
How can you and Leliana be candidates? You're not even priests.
It's not without precedent. Amar the Third was sister to the Emperor, and Galatea a commoner. Leliana and I were, at least, part of the Chantry hierarchy. It would be accepted.
If you don't want it, then tell them so.
Surely it was never meant to be like this. The Chantry, the Circle of Magi, the Templars... This cannot be what they intended when it all began. The Chantry should provide faith, hope. Instead, it cannot veer from its course, even in the face of certain death.
If you're concerned, then make it better.
Did you know Varric is Andrastian? Oh, he blasphemes with every second breath, but deep down he believes. His heart is virtuous. But he would never step foot in a chantry. It should be the first place to which the virtuous turn. It needs to change. Perhaps I must be the one to change it.
Your determination is admirable.
Some men would call it an unattractive trait.
I'm not those men.
Truer words have not been spoken.
Who's using flattery now? What would you change about the Chantry?
The Circle of Magi has its place, but it needs reform. Let the mages govern themselves with our help. Let the Templars stand not as the jailers of mages, but as protectors of the innocent. We must be vigilant, but we must also be compassionate to all peoples of Thedas, human or no. That is what I would change.
So this is your new crusade?
I've agreed to nothing yet.
And if the Chantry calls on you?
Then I will do whatever I can, for as long as I can. I suppose I should not be so concerned. The clerics speak my name for now, nothing more. For now, restoring order and stopping Corypheus remain our priority.
He wants what?
I don't know. I just bought the message.
We'll take this one back. No. No! Possibly in a month. No!
Yes, Sarah. Of course.
Wait! I suppose... Ugh, I can't believe this. Yes, I can deliver.
Oh, good.
It's always wonderful to speak with you.
I was hoping we could spend some time together.
With you? Always.
Winding road, defiant in the vile. Uncertain form
for hope. We'll make good use of it.
When met with a multitude of smiles.
One for the Empress. For Gaspar. Briana. The Duchess. And Corypheus. Right in the dangle bag.
Well, remind me to stay on your good side.
Don't worry, you're sparkling compared to that lot. A cook here, a footman there. What's it matter, right, so long as there's a butt for the throne? A pretty one, sure. But how many lives are worth one empress's arse? Ugh, that place. Should have just thrown in some bees and slammed the doors.
I don't know. Want to stop a party, I think you go earwigs.
I hate those things, with their little pinchy butts. Josephine should add that to her paper threats. You know the real lesson from all this? Never sleep with an empress. We patched their spat, Briala and the Selene. But without their breakup, none of it would have happened like that.
That was a mistake on their part. It made everything worse.
Wrong way around, Inquisitor. It started worse. Lots of people died before there was a hole in the sky. That's who you're saving. If you get a chance, maybe remind them not to be idiots.
Love seeing you, yeah?
I'll be back if I need you.
Go on.
So it's true. Some look to Cassandra or even me as Justinia's successor. I never thought the idea would gain momentum. Of course, with the other candidates out of the picture.
Is becoming divine something you really want?
When Justinia was alive, I would have laughed at anyone who even suggested that I could be her successor. Things have changed. Still, I don't know. Restoring the Chantry will be like trying to steer a sinking vessel through a storm.
Whoever becomes divine will have my support if she requires it.
And I'm sure whoever becomes divine will absolutely require the Inquisition's backing. The Chantry is faltering, but it still has influence over the people. Who tells the people what's right? Who do they look to in times of peril? A divine with enough support can change the Chantry. And with it, Thedas. But this is a discussion for later. If Corypheus wins, finding a new divine will be the least of our problems. A message from Divine Justinia.
That's a shock. You're all right reading it?
Thank you for the concern, Inquisitor. But I am. This message was written months, perhaps even years ago, to be delivered to me if she died. I've heard of such contingency plans. A sudden death often leaves loose ends. I'm to go to Valence, a small village on the Waking Sea. There is something hidden there.
Do you know what you're looking for?
The Divine was a powerful woman who used her position to obtain all sorts of things. Whatever she hid in Valence would very likely benefit the Inquisition and must be kept from falling into the wrong hands. If I'm lucky, she will have instructions for me.
You take your instructions from me? What sort of help can a dead Divine give you?
I don't know. Perhaps something to do with the Chantry. Or it could be personal. She guided me for many years, Inquisitor, as a divine and as a friend. There are days when I still look to her for advice, only to remember that I am alone.
Why hide things in Valence? What's so special about it?
Justinia was revered mother at the Chantry there for many years before she became the divine. It is a place that holds great meaning for her.
I'll help in whatever way I can.
Wonderful. I was hoping you would agree to come with me to Valence. One more thing. If what is hidden in Valence is as valuable as I think, we're not going to be the only ones looking for it. I shall meet you at the Chantry in Valence. Try not to delay.